Islamic law allows marriage not by age, but by maturity, as you quoted rightly, and puberty. Once a girl reaches the age of puberty and is assumed to be matured, and who determines who's matured? The parents.
So,
by Islamic law.
So you are convinced that there will be a 13-year-old,
yes,
who can be considered matured and ready for marriage,
as just determined by any other law in the West,
70-year-old,
even the so-called Western countries, the so-called
we are talking about Nigeria.
So
I'm focusing on Nigeria.
In Nigerian law, we are a country of faithful people, Christian and Muslims. You check Bible. People will tell, some bishops will tell you that 12 years, 13 years, they still talk about the age of puberty.
Isn't that so? Because a lot of these books were based 400-500 years ago. And so societies have changed. At that time that you're talking about, even young men used to marry at 16, 18. And so a 13-year-old may be betrothed to a man, but he's probably likely to be 3-4 years older than her.
As far as
not 20, 30, 40 years older than her.
Islam, Quran is for all times. That is, I believe. You see, the difference is that you cannot...
No, but the Quran does not explicitly say that you should marry a girl at a young age.
Hadith has said so. Hadith has said so. Who interprets Quran? Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. The messenger of God of Islam interpret what is in the Quran.
Are you talking about his marriage to Aisha?
I'm not even talking about his marriage. I'm talking about your own definition of...
Yeah, it says maturity.
No.
It didn't say
so
puberty.
You focused on the physical.
You focused on the physical.
No, I have agreed with your interpretation of maturity and puberty.
Mm-hmm.
What is maturity and puberty? What are the characteristics of a matured girl or a girl that attained the age of puberty, as far as that definition is concerned?
Let me take you a little back. This is not the first time that you've been involved in controversy around child marriage. You married an Egyptian girl a few years ago, and the allegations was that she was 13 years old. She was the daughter of your driver. And you basically paid a dowry of $100,000 to be able to marry her. In other words, taking advantage of the poverty of the family. Can you shed light on what exactly happened? Because we seem to find you again and again in the midst of this sort of controversy.
Allegations.
Yes. And so this is the
facts.
Time to sort of, okay. So
allegations are not facts.
Okay.
First of all, I got married under Islamic law.
Okay.
Whether an Egyptian or a Nigerian, it is done in Abuja, in the central mosque of Abuja. And I didn't marry my drivers. I don't have an Egyptian driver. I don't live in Egypt. All my drivers are Nigerians.
Okay.
Therefore, all these allegations, as you said, are not facts. If you are arguing or you are discussing based on facts, the fact of the matter is that I got married in Abuja, central mosque, and the marriage was witnessed by the Sharia Court of Appeal, which issued certificate at the time of the marriage that this marriage was conducted and consummated under Islamic law and was in order. And that's why the attorney general of the...
How old was your wife?
The issue of age, as I told you, does not matter as far as Islamic law is concerned.
Was she 13,
but she was
mature, as they reported?
She was not 13.
A mature 13.
She was not 13. She was not 13.
Okay.
But I know she was matured enough, as testified by the certificate of marriage given to me by the Sharia Court of Appeal of Abuja.
Okay. Now, you've got more than one wife.
Yes.
How many of those wives are under 21?
Why? This is so personal. You see,
yes,
the fact
it
is.
And
the fact is that.
And if you want me to explain why,
all,
I can explain
all,
why.
Yeah, okay. Why do you ask the question?
Well, because these are the issues being debated as to whether you are using.
At 21.
You are using. No, I said under 21. Whether you are using the guise of Islam.
Let me give you an example.
To basically.
Let me give you an example.
Give justification for your own personal
let
behavior.
Let me give you an example. My wife, one of the wives I married, was a medical doctor.
I know her.
So you, that's why I asked you yourself. I tell you.
But you have other wives apart from her.
If I married a medical doctor, then you can determine how old she was when I married her by going to primary school, secondary school, and university, spending 7 years in university, doing an internship, and youth service.
Well, since then you've married otherwise.
So the issue is, as far as I'm concerned, I'm a Muslim, and I'm entitled to live my life according to my faith, according to Islamic law. So long as I don't do any action that is against Islamic law, I am covered by Nigerian Constitution.
The Nigerian Constitution is being amended. And even if we go with the words of the Senate President, David Mark, what you are doing essentially is blackmailing people to make sure that that Constitution is not amended in such a way that people like you can be held to account.
So all sections
That is what the Senate President said, that you blackmailed people into voting for this, for not to expunge this particular
amendment. So all the other revoting that was made, Senate was blackmailed. Or it's only Yarima that blackmailed the Senate.
Well, that is what the Senate President said.
Well,
we were not there. I was not there. I'm just telling you what he said.
That's why it's semantics. It's his own statement. And he does not mean any harm to me, I'm sure. You see, the fact is that they were voting three times on three occasions. Two occasions because before I even asked for a voting on my own issue. When I raised the first issue, the Senate President said, no, you cannot revisit because voting has already taken place. And I sat down. I went to pray. I came back. Then there was revoting on two issues. And I demanded for a revote. So how can it be blackmailed?
And before the revote took place, you stood up and basically made a passionate appeal to members and whipped up religious sentiments, apparently. Are you worried about the fact that already in Nigeria there is a lot of distrust among Muslims and Christians? There are tensions all over the place, both religious and tribal. Don't you worry that when you bring up the issue of religion time and time again and using religion to sort of push for a certain argument, that you are further growing the rift between the two religions?
Let me just quote the Pope that just spoke in Brazil, who says gay people should be given freedom. The fact is that religious interpretations, faith, issues of faith are very important in life. The camp president, for example, in Nigeria, camp chairman, said he was going to lead a demonstration to the National Assembly based on his own understanding, but he also said he was against gay marriage. So those gays who are seeing that they have the right to be gays are saying that he is using religious sentiments. So there's no way in life you are either a Muslim, a Christian, a Jew, or a Hindu. So long as we don't appreciate the differences that exist between us and appreciate the fact that we need to live together peacefully and allow others freedom of their choice to be Muslim or Christians, this can continue not only in Nigeria, all over the world.
Allowing Senator Yarima to practice his faith.
That's all. So those who want to believe based on their custom, live their life based on their culture and tradition, they should be allowed to practice the custom.
Okay, I'm afraid I have to personalize it again. So if this is about allowing you to practice your religion, you have four daughters.
Yes.
Two are married.
Yeah.
How many did you marry in their teen years?
I have 28 children.
I know, but I know of four daughters.
Three got married.
Married, yes.
And two are getting married.
Yes.
One is getting married September 6th.
Okay.
At 16 years.
Okay.
So she's not 18.
Well, the other two that I know got married at 18 and 19, because they were at university.
17.
At the time.
17 and 18 years.
Okay. So you're practicing what you preach even
that's
in your
it.
House.
16 is getting married on the 6th of September. Because she's matured. If you see her, you yourself will advise me to get her married.
We accept that your intentions are honorable and what you're doing is in line with religion.
Yeah.
There's always the pervert, the man who is a pedophile, who really it's about sex with underage children. How do we guard children against those kind of people if we don't have the laws in place?
You are not allowed to marry out your daughter as you define, until she's matured and she reached the age of puberty.
But if you marry
your daughter out, the law, Islamic law, will apply on you. So children are protected under Islamic law.
If maturity cannot be measured by an independent measure such as age,
yes,
how do you form laws that will apply across board?
The law is already there.
No, but how do you apply the law if you don't have an independent measure of when a child is mature and is subject to